It's the biggest, they say, the most beautiful, the most spectacular event of this era, the New York World's Fair.
The organizers of the 1964 World's Fair billed the event as one for the ages, and America was ready to be impressed. One reason was statements like this by World's Fair President Robert Moses.
How will this fair differ from other World's Fairs?
Oh, it's bigger. There's more to see and more ground to cover.
But for all its size and hype, the event failed to leave a lasting mark on the culture. In fact, World Fair ceased to be relevant altogether, thanks in part to technology exhibited in 64. Color television was a big deal at the fair, and Bell Systems showed off a phone with a built-in camera.
Someday, people may want to see as well as talk over the telephone.
Telecommunication, and especially TV, would bring news and entertainment into American living rooms, which meant people no longer had to congregate in large crowds to learn about the world.
This is the stage for Act One of the Carousel Theater Progress.
Meanwhile, Walt Disney brought animatronic robots to New York. This gave visitors a taste of another, more transfixing destination, Disneyland. You could say the World's Fair put itself out of business, and large cultural changes pushed it to the side. In 1964, race riots shook New York, Philadelphia, and other cities. The governor of Alabama, George Wallace, ran a segregationist campaign for president, while Lyndon Johnson pushed a landmark civil rights bill through Congress. These events shaped the America of today. And the World's Fair, it left much more quietly than it arrived.